Holy Quran states, you will certainly find the nearest in affection to those who believe to be those who say, we are Christian. This is because there are priests and monks among them and because they do not behave arrogantly. Which may be part of the wisdom behind why Imam Khomeini gave gifts to Christians on Christmas Eve during...
Hey yo, what's up beautiful man? Ugly people, what's poppin' man? What's poppin'? It's your boy JEWSY, again and again and again and again and again. But you can call me Keegan though. So right about now, we're gonna do another reaction. But before I get to the reaction, guys, I wanna thank everybody out there, man, for subscribing to my channel. You are the best, man. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. So right about now, we're gonna do another reaction. And this one right there was suggested by, I think, two people. They suggested that I should go react to 10 things about Jesus and Islam. So without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
There's something you should know about Jesus in Islam.
All right.
The Muslim greeting of Assalamu Alaikum, which means peace be upon you, is not only something which was practiced by the Holy Prophet, but also by Jesus. The Holy Bible says, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, peace be with you. In Islam, we believe in the miraculous birth of Jesus Christ. To the Virgin Mary, who is regarded as one of the great ladies of light, she is also the only woman mentioned in the Quran by name. The Holy Quran states, she, Mary, said, oh my Lord, how shall I have a son when no man has touched me. God said, so it will be, for God creates what he wills. Jesus is mentioned more times in the Holy Quran than Muhammad. While the Holy Quran is a message sent to all of humanity by God through the Holy Prophet, Muhammad is mentioned 4 times, while Jesus is mentioned 25 times.
Wait. Jesus is mentioned 25 times in the Quran and Muhammad only 4 times. This is like, I don't know, I think this is news for me. Like, I totally didn't know anything about that, but this is so like, I didn't know anything about that, man. That's really, really amazing.
Muslims believe in the great miracles performed by Jesus, the son of Mary. Jesus brought the dead back to life by the will of God. He healed the lepers by the will of God. And he walked on water by the will of God. As well as these miracles, the Holy Quran also testifies that Jesus spoke from the cradle when he was just a baby. They said, how can we talk to one who is a child in the cradle? Jesus said, verily, I am a servant of God. He has given me the scripture and made me a prophet. Muslims believe that Christians are the closest to them in affection. The Holy Quran states, you will certainly find the nearest in affection to those who believe to be those who say, we are Christian. This is because there are priests and monks among them and because they do not behave arrogantly. Which may be part of the wisdom behind why Imam Khomeini gave gifts to Christians on Christmas Eve during his exile to France. Islam is the one true divine religion. But believe it or not, Muslims do not believe that Christians and Jews will go to hell. The Holy Quran states, surely those who believe and those who are Jews and the Christians and the Sabians, whoever believes in Allah and the last day and does good, they shall have their reward from their Lord. And there is no fear for them, nor shall they grieve. The criteria set down by the Holy Quran for anyone who wishes to earn the rewards of God are, number one, to believe in God and the final day, and number two, to do good deeds. This is for anyone who is not properly introduced to Islam. For the Quran also says, surely the true religion with Allah is Islam.
Number 7.
Muslims do not believe in the Trinity. Many Christians believe that God is composed of 3, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and that these 3 are in fact one. But the Holy Quran states, people of the book, do not go to excess in your religion and do not say anything about God except the truth. The Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, was nothing more than a messenger of God. So believe in God and his messengers and do not speak of a trinity. Stop this. That is better for you. God is only one God. He is far above having a son.
That's true.
Muslims do not believe that Jesus was God himself or that he was the literal son of God. God, i.e. Allah, is the limitless, the omnipresent, in all times and all places. The moment somebody attributes to God a bodily form, they have limited God in their own perception. This isn't God. God can't be seen with the physical eye because anything that can be seen has been limited by the mere fact that the perception has been able to grasp that thing. When Imam Ali, the first Imam and the fourth Khalifa, was asked, have you ever seen God? He replied, I do not worship the God I have not seen, and that the human eye cannot see Allah. Rather, the eyes of the heart can perceive Him. Jesus was one of those who understood this, and God gave him the ability to perform miracles in order to guide other people towards the path of God. But then people came and started saying that Jesus himself is God. Did Jesus himself ever say, I am God, so worship me? Did he ever approve of being called the Son of God? The Holy Bible states, demons came out of many people shouting, you are the Son of God. But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak. Furthermore, there are numerous verses which confirm that Jesus accepted the title of teacher and prophet, and that he referred to himself as the Son of Man. The Holy Quran also confirms, and remember when Allah will say on the day of resurrection, O Jesus, Son of Mary, did you say to men, worship me and my mother as two gods besides Allah? Jesus will reply, glory be to you. Never did I say to them aught except what you did command me to say. Worship Allah, my Lord, and your Lord. Does the Holy Bible also contain verses which chime with this? Yes. The Holy Bible states, by myself, I can do nothing, for I seek not to please myself, but him who sent me. In another place it says, for I did not speak on my own, but the Father who sent me commanded me to say all that I have spoken. Some might argue that Jesus here is clearly referring to God as his begotten Father, quoting this verse of the Holy Bible. For God so loved this world that he gave his only Son. Could it be that the term Son of God in the Bible means something entirely different to what many Christians have taken it to mean? Son of God is actually used in other places in the Bible to refer to other than Jesus. David is referred to as the Son of God. In another place it says, this is what the Lord says, Israel is my firstborn son. And yet in another place it says, the son of Enosh, the son of Seth, the son of Adam, the son of God. Could it be that the term father used in the Bible actually refers to something that corresponds to the Rabb that Islam teaches? I.e. the one who nourishes and sustains. And that this omnipotent, nourishing, sustaining God is the Father of all people and all creation? The Holy Bible states, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Yet many Christians argue that he was the begotten literal son of God, since he had no father. If being born without a father makes one God or the son of God, then surely Adam is more entitled, since he was born without a mother or a father. Nay, the reality is that nobody is the biological or the begotten or the literal son of God. God is way beyond these lower animalistic functions of reproduction. God is unique, God the source of everything. He has not fathered anyone, nor is he fathered, and there is nothing comparable to him.
Number 9.
Muslims do not believe that Jesus was crucified. Now, this is a core Christian belief, and it relates to the concept of atonement. According to this belief, Jesus died in order to save mankind from sin. But Muslims do not accept this, believing that God is just, and that every person is held accountable for his own actions. You do something good, you're gonna be rewarded. Now, you do something bad and don't repent, the Holy Quran states, so whoever does an atom's weight of good will see it, and whoever does an atom's weight of evil will see it. And also that a burdened soul cannot bear the burden of another. Would it be just to punish Jesus for a sin committed by someone else? The Islamic perspective is that Jesus was never crucified. The Quran says that they said, we have killed the Messiah Jesus, son of Mary, the messenger of God. But they did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, though it was made to appear like that to them. God raised him up to himself. God is mighty, wise. Did any of the disciples or the writers of the Gospels see the crucifixion? In Mark 14:50, it says that the disciples forsook Jesus and fled. According to this, they ran away and did not witness the crucifixion. In fact, what we do have is John 20:17 telling us that Mary Magdalene approached the sepulchre to find it empty, and then she saw Jesus and, astonished, went to touch him, to which Jesus responded, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. So Jesus, even in the Bible, is seen as unharmed, and he's ascending to God. But if not Jesus, who was actually crucified? Whoever it was cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? It doesn't sound like Jesus, any man, let alone a messenger who has a strong connection to the all-merciful, all-powerful God, and trusts him would never ever utter such words of despair. If you have absolute trust in someone, you would never say, "Why have you left me alone? Why have you abandoned me? Why have you forsaken me?" And there are many other reasons for why Jesus was never crucified. And as the Quran says, it was just made to seem so. Muslims believe in the second coming of Christ. Jesus will return along with the Mahdi, and together they will establish peace, justice, and balance across the planet. The Holy Prophet said, "The Mahdi will turn his face to Jesus and he will say to him, 'Go ahead and say the prayer.' Jesus will say, 'The prayer has been set up only for you.' So Jesus will pray behind a man who is among my sons. Thus will they pray together to the one God, and thus will truth be established on the earth forever."
All right.
Merry Christmas to everyone out there. May God free Palestine, the land of Jesus Christ.
Okay. That was super amazing right there. I mean, 10 things about Jesus in Islam. To be honest, I didn't know that Jesus was mentioned like 25 times. Like, to be just 100% honest, I didn't know anything about that. And then, what do you call this? Muhammad was only mentioned like 4 times? I can't even comprehend that, like, to be honest, man. I mean, all the things that have been said here, some of the things are so intriguing, and some of the things I kind of had knowledge about. But all in all, everything is just really, really amazing. Anyway, guys, just let me know what you think about 10 things about Jesus in Islam. What do you think about it? Just write down in my comment section below. Anyway, guys, if you feel like I reacted to this video in a better way, just give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down in my comment section. Tell me exactly what you feel about my reaction and what you feel about this video right here, 10 things about Jesus in Islam. Just let me know and let's just talk to each other and educate each other about the Quran. And yeah, let us just, in the comment section below, just let me know. And the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. The more you keep on subscribing, the more you give me the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you better content. And last but not the least, guys, always be a lead, and I'm gonna see you in the next video, and peace out.